In a previous video, we looked at a quadratic equation. Now we're going to make things slightly tougher by looking at a cubic function. So I want to get rid of this quadratic. So if I come into y equals and I just clear, I'll get rid of the quadratic. Now my cubic equation is going to be x, this one to the power of 3, minus 2x squared. So I can use this one here. Plus x, and then plus 5. So this is just a cubic equation or function that I've made up. I'm going to graph this first of all. I'm just going to see if I've got a window. Well, I've got a window here. Something funny looks like it's happening here. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit by using my window function again. Now, there was quite a bit of dead area around the x-axis, you can see. So again, if I'd use this one, minus 5, so it'll be this function, should get it right. And I'm going to go up to 5. I'm going to come down. I don't want it to be a minimum of negative 25. I'm maybe using negative 5 and up as far as 10. So I know that's what I will need to do. Graph again. There we are. Now my graph is going up, curving down, and coming back. I want to find two things. I want to find F2. So F2, F2 is where the function brackets 2. And to do that, I'm going to go second calc, and I'm looking for a value, number 1. So this is where I make X2. So again, this is F2 in brackets, and I want to find the number. Dead easy. I just type that in, and it goes to where F is 2. And it will tell me straight away x equals 7. So that's the first one, is when f brackets 2. If I'm doing a different function, such as the function is equal to 2, so it's fx equals 2, there's another way of doing that. And it's to come back to the graph and to enter y equals 2. So it's like I've got two graphs, the function and 2. Again, this is where fx equals 2. And I'm going to graph this. You can now see I've got a straight line, one point there. And I go to second calc. And I haven't got anything here. I'm going to go down to intersect, find the intersection point between these two graphs. For the first curve, I'm just going to put it near the intersection. The blue one. Second curve is the red one. Here, it tells me that the intersection point is negative 0.864. So this is how we find F2 and Fx equals 2, which is the one that's on the screen.